This is the second video in a series of exercises where we're exploring the if statement. In this video, we'll be combining if statements and for loops. Hey, I'm Victor Stepanoff. I'll be guiding you through this beginner Blender Python exercise. In this video, we'll be continuing working with if statements. We're going to be building on top of the knowledge you gained from the first video, so make sure to see that video if you haven't already. All right, let's open Blender and let's navigate into the scripting workspace. Let's hit new. Let's delete everything from the scene by hovering over the 3D viewport and hitting A, X, and then delete. At the very top of our script, I'm going to import BPY and random. We're going to be using these modules to first allow Python to access Blender's functionality. That's going to be the BPY module. And then we'll need to generate some random numbers, and we're going to be using the random module for that. Let's get the code for the icosphere and the cube. Let's hover over the 3D viewport and hit Shift A and then add a cube, and then do the same thing and add an icosphere. In the info panel down below, we can just select these two commands and then copy them and then paste them right underneath here. So we'll be needing that. I'm going to remove everything, all the parameters except the location from these two function calls. And I'm going to remove it like so. Okay, let's clear the scene and run the script. And it adds a cube and an icosphere you can see in the outliner right here. Let's create a for loop and repeat this code right here 10 times. So I'm gonna use the for keyword, and then I in, and then range, and then 10. And then I'm gonna select both of these lines by holding shift and the down arrow, and then I'm gonna hit tab to indent both of these lines. Now let's clear the scene and run this code again. So nothing really changed. We have a bunch of icospheres and cubes in the center of the scene. You can only kind of tell by the outliner that there's multiple objects there. You can maybe move this around by hitting G and just digging out the icospheres or the cubes, right? Let's clear that. And now let's add an if statement that would randomly select either an icosphere or a cube. So we're gonna write an if, and then random, and then rand int, and we're gonna go between 0 and 1. You remember from the previous video, 1 is true and 0 is false, so it's gonna be randomly selecting 1 or 0 and evaluating this Boolean expression right here as true or false. Right, so I'm going to select this and indent it again because we need to indent all the code. So now this is the body of for loop and this is the body of the if statement. And since I want to either have a cube or an icosphere, I will use the else keyword, meaning that either this code is going to be executed or this right here. So let's run this code. And now if you look into the outliner right here, you can see that again, there's a number of icospheres and cubes. Not really clear, are they getting selected by random or not? So let's space out these objects, and we're gonna be using the I right here, since that changes every single iteration as we go through the for loop. We're going to space them by modifying the location of each of these icospheres and cubes. So I'm going to just select and replace the x coordinate, right? So now we're going to be spacing out these icospheres and cubes. Let's clear the scene and run the script again. All right. So now I'm going to hit control space and to get a closer look. And as you can see, we have a random selection of ecospheres and cubes. Let's run that a couple more times. I'm gonna delete that and run it again. And now you can see there's more cubes, right? Let's delete that and run it again. And now there's more icospheres. Right, now let's create a different Boolean expression. And instead of having this random generator right here, I wanna see if I can have half the objects cubes and then the other half icospheres. So I could achieve that by comparing I to, let's just say, 5. And now when I is gonna be greater than 5, right, we're gonna get a cube, and if it's less, then we're gonna get an icosphere. So let's select everything and delete and run this script. So as you can see, we first have, the first half is gonna be the icospheres, and then the next half is gonna be the cubes, right? So let's go back. Probably a more accurate way to do that, since there's only 4 cubes right here, I should have used greater or equal to 5. So let's do that and let's run it. Okay, now that looks better. So we have 5 icospheres and 5 cubes. And if you're learning something new, make sure to hit the like button. It will help me tremendously. Okay, now let's write this code slightly in a different way to get the same result. Let's add a current location and set it to 0. Then each time, in each iteration of the for loop, we're going to change that, and we're going to calculate the new value of the current location by taking the old value and then adding 2, right? So similar thing as we're multiplying I by 2 on each iteration, we can just add 2 to the current location. So instead of using I right here, I'm just going to use current location. So let's delete that and let's run it. And you can see that we are getting the same result with slightly different code. All right, for your first exercise, we're going to be creating this scene right here. We're going to be setting the current location to -20 and repeating this for loop 20 times. What do we need to change in this script right here to get that scene? Pause the video now and try it on your own. All right, I hope you managed to do that on your own. And here's how I would do it. So since we're changing on the Z axis each iteration, let's move the current location from X to Z right here. And let's do the same thing for the icosphere. All right, and now if you notice that as soon as the current location became greater than 0, we started to add icospheres. So I'm gonna check the current location, set it less than and then 0. Let's delete everything from the scene and rerun this. All right, here is what you should have got, right? So here's the code. And if you did it in a slightly different way, that's okay. It's the main point of this exercise is to get a similar scene like this. Okay, and for your second exercise, what code changes do we need to make to get this scene right here? Notice that the objects are randomly selected, so you might want to use randint right here. We're not going to be changing the current location or this part right here, so please try that on your own. Pause the video now. All right, to get that scene that I asked, you need to first change this right here to randint, right? And we're going to be randomly selecting between a cube and an icosphere. And to make those meshes go in a diagonal way as shown in the scene, you would need to just change and set the current location for all the location properties. So let's clear the scene and run that. All right, and you can see that we got this scene right here. All right, I hope you enjoyed this exercise. I'll be putting out a couple more videos about if statements, so make sure to subscribe. And thank you so much for watching.